Today you'll learn how to split photos for Instagram in Photoshop. Make sure you stick until the end because I will show you three ways to do that. The first method works only for the version Photoshop CC, any of them. If you want your Instagram photo to be 1000 by 1000 pixels, put the weight 3000 and the height 1000. If you want another size for your Instagram photo, multiply by 3 that size for the weight and for the height write that size. Go to View, New Guide Layout, check Columns and write 3. Make sure the size of the photo you want to split has the weight 3000. Now just move it to the white file. You can leave it like that and make the step that I will show you at 1 minute and 50 seconds. But I prefer to make a collage for Instagram that shows the entire photo. If you do, then follow me. Go to Image, Canvas Size, choose Pixels, at High add 1000 pixels, so it's gonna be 2000 pixels. Go again to View, New Guide Layout, check Rows and write 2. Gutter should be 0. Now choose Slice Tool. Select like I do. Go to File, Export, Save for Web. Make sure for each selection the format is JPEG and the quality 100 maximum. In the next weeks, I will make a tutorial that will show you how to make a collage with multiple photos for Instagram, which involves this split method. Make sure you subscribe to this channel so you don't miss it. Now I want to show you the next way to split photos for Instagram, so I will undo everything. Ctrl plus R, press on the select tool and from left drag that blue line to 33.3. Next, do it again, but this time go to 66.6. Now drag from top that blue line to 50. And now you do the steps that I did at 1 minute and 50 seconds. Now it's time for the third way to split photos for Instagram. Create a new document 3000 by 1000. Again, create another document, this time 1000 by 1000. Give to this square a color. Now move it to the first document like I do. choose the slice tool and select like me. Now move the square next to the selection. Again, choose the slice tool, select. And select what's left. And move the photo to this document. Save it as we did before. File, export, save for web. And that's it with this tutorial. Thanks for watching. I will see you next week.